the presentation as well as my webcam. Are we good to go? Yep, okay. Cool. All right, before we start with the second session, anyone want to share any thoughts or afterthoughts of what we discussed yesterday? Any specific feedback or any ideas you would like to share with everyone? We can start with that. Any
hello. Hi. I'm Arvind. Actually, yesterday I missed your session. From computer, basically, and I'm a working professional. I'm a supplement. I have nearly 10 years experience in system admin. Yes.
Okay. And where do you work?
Yeah. It's an academic institution. My college is PhD College of Technology. It's somewhat in South and very popular in most of South India. Top 10, top 20 colleges. They used to teach engineering, you know. So I'm in back end.
Good to have this, Arvind. Thanks for joining. What would you be interested in hearing? Yesterday we covered some of the, but I think since you already into some kind of jobs, you already have all those things. See, this the idea of those sessions are to speak about what kind of skills everyone would need when we work in future, right? When digital takes over most of our working life, personal life, what kind of skills we would need and those kind of things. I guess your experience may also chime in with what you would like to add on to the discussion. Okay, so happy to have you on this. Thanks. Anyone of our yesterday's attendees? I see Pramod, you are also new. I don't think you were yesterday on the session. Am I right? I see few new names. Pramod, Shravani. I don't know if Shravani was also there yesterday. Okay, no problem. So Agamman, for topic for today, we will be talking about the skills. Okay, I'm not watching any more public chat. Okay, so if you want to say something, please feel free to unmute and talk. So today, yesterday, we looked at various different types of jobs which will come in our way, or what are those? If you look at the video which we saw yesterday, the robot, what kind of what the mindset or what is the purpose of building those robots, and how they are going to change almost everything? Let's get to the specifics of what skills are we talking about. Let's look at what essentially. I'm not going to recommend any courses, as I said earlier. It's not about telling you, okay, learn SQL or this programming language or that programming language or things like that. We will be talking about, in general, basic skills or basic digital skills or other skills which will help you work in any environment, any setup, for that matter. Okay. So let's start. I have a few questions just to gauge what is your understanding and where are you in terms of the current digital understanding. Okay, so the first question is, why digital technology is adopted? Is it because of speed, reach, accuracy, or scalability. When I say scalability, scalability means to make something bigger, or even the main purpose of industrialization was that when you do one thing and then people want to grow things, you know, that's when the technology came in. And instead of building one sheep per day, probably they could build 10 or 20 and things like that. So that's expansion is what is called as scalability. You expand or you grow your things. So that is scalability. So do you think digital technologies are adopted across spectrum because of speed, reach, accuracy, or scalability? A, B, C, D. Let me know your thoughts. Okay, I see half of you have responded. Other half, I will just give a few seconds to complete the poll. Okay, while others poll, let me just give some more thought to it, you know, so that you will understand. Each of those are important, okay? But, you know, I would rather say that it depends on what are you trying to achieve using that technology, okay? So there can be areas where you want speed. Okay, so for example, calculations. Human mind can do calculation, but machines, like, that's the reason why we had calculators or the computers in first place for their. So most of you, as you are polling, you are talking about speed as one of the key factor. However, reach is also another aspect which we have to understand. Okay, and why I'm spending more time explaining all those things is for that, so that you understand the context out of which you will be talking about the skills. Okay, so reach is something, you know, like, for example, as a person, you can probably go to a single area or single person, but if you record your video and publish it, then you can reach a much more wider audience, or lot many people can see you, hear you, listen to your thoughts, and that kind of thing. So that's where the reach comes into picture. And accuracy, again, it had been one of the most important factor for digital, actually, or for that matter, any technology. Okay, we felt that machines can be more accurate than the human beings. You remember yesterday we spoke about your self-driving cars. One of the key key factor why they are considering self-driving car is actually accuracy. Okay, the number, their speculation or their main intention is that the number of accidents which human drivers make, the machine, the self-driving car, that will encounter less number of errors or less number of accidents. Okay, so basically the usage of technology is also to make sure that it is much more accurate than humanly possible. Okay, and then of course the scalability, as I mentioned earlier, it is to make things bigger. Scalability had been one of the key thing which I hear from clients across the world, that they want to adopt, or they any project for that matter which we get in Cognizant, or for that matter any other companies which I worked on, every company picks up the project. And one of the key asks is that scalability, and also the kind of solutions which we build. And this is a very important aspect for us to understand when you will start working in future in, suppose if you work in IT organization, or for that matter anywhere else, you have to have a bigger picture. You know, you need to know where this is heading, where else it can be used, how big it can become, Do you restrict yourself to a specific area? If not, then you need to have those factors considered. That is what is called as scalability. You know, your product is scalable and it can cater to lot many people. Let's take example of, say, your primary this courses. Okay, we are doing it for just primary three schools student, but then it can be scaled up and then you can open it up for everyone to participate. That's called as scaling up. Okay, so you are getting lot many people who are not studying in tamarind tree school and they can also participate. So the scope of the it is scaling up and you are using it for lot many things. Okay, so that is why those technologies are used. Let's look at other area. Okay, now you have got adopted digital technologies. Now what is the, when you choose any digital technology, what is the critical factor you consider? Is it the ease of use? Is it the security, the features, or accessibility? So accessibility also, let me elaborate a little bit. Accessibility means different to different people. Okay. Typically, it also means that if you have a specific handicap or if you do not have access to certain thing, how easily you can access the technology. That's why this is also becoming one of the key factor, though not very usually spoken of, but many a times that is also one of the key factor determining which application we need to use. Okay, I also see many of you are polling and most of you are actually inclined towards features. Okay, all right, so I think almost everyone has responded, and most of you, almost one third of you, are talking about features. Okay, so you know that's one of the key reason why every technology product is actually spending a lot more time rolling out different features and different features to their product continuously, because as you can see, you know, from this sample audience of 15-16 people, most of them actually look after the features while adopting any digital platform. However, other to my mind, you know, one of the key thing is also security. We are going to talk about this security aspect a little bit in detail, because that is one area which I wanted to focus in terms of skills also. You know, how do we look at this particular aspect of security in using any digital platform, or for that matter, any app or technology which you use? It is very essential for us to look at security aspect of it as well. Okay, next question. In your household, how many digitally connected or connected to internet devices you have? 1, 2, 3 or more than 3? Excellent, I thought so. Most of you have more than 3. Okay, but at least one. I did not mention none, because obviously since you are connected to this course, it is definitely that you have at least one device. So okay.
Can you check the chat? I have about 6, I would say.
Okay, good.
Double.
That's fine.
I have 3 phones. One is an old phone, then I have 2 of my parents, then I have 1 work machine, one of our personal, 2 personal machines, then this tab I am currently watching on.
Okay.
I have a Raspberry Pi, those small machines, one of those.
That's okay. It's not about the numbers, actually.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
Yes. That's okay. See, the point I wanted to discuss here is not how many devices, but if you see the kind of devices which are connected to internet, okay? So we have, as you also mentioned, we have mobile phones, we have our laptops, our computers, we have iPads, we have gaming devices, we have smartwatches. So basically, if you see, most of our time, our waking time, we are spending with the devices. And I mentioned this yesterday also, you know, it is voraciously, it is capturing our data very aggressively. So the more number of devices which you have connected, or the more connected interactions which you have in your waking time, that much data you are actually spreading across this web, you know, worldwide, where your data goes and it sits there. So that is what I want to highlight when I ask this question, that each one of us is so much addicted, so much connected. So it becomes all the more important for us to even be responsible for the kind of interaction. The next slide, which is about the numbers. Okay, so these are the numbers which are published by EDC. It is a international data corporation. They conduct various surveys, and based on their surveys, on an average day, if you see in 2019, that is last year which we completed, look at the number of WhatsApp messages which we are sending on a daily basis. Okay, 65 billion messages. YouTube users, how many? Yesterday when I asked this question, most of you said YouTube is your favorite app. So there are 6 billion videos which are seen by people on a daily basis. What this means, you know, and this is continuously expanding. On every day we interact, and pandemic has the COVID situation which we have today, this number is increasing dramatically. As you see, there is a prediction by IDC, I think they might revise this number this year, but they predict that humanity in totality, collectively, 29 trillion digital transaction every day. When they say digital transaction, means any of those interactions which we have, even for that matter, even if you are sending one message across, that is a transaction which you are doing. Okay, and also this is very important to note, that most of our daily or waking life, we are interacting on the digital platform. Even for that matter, I don't watch anything live TV or anything anymore, but I watch streaming videos. Okay, I have a smart TV, so everything is on the through the internet. So this data and everything is expanding continuously. It is creating that halo around you, and you are being tracked. Okay, so that is the reason why we wanted to speak on the kind of skills you would need to build. But before we get into those skills, I wanted, this is on the personal level. Okay, most of the apps which you see here, these are all personal apps: WhatsApp, YouTube, Instagram, or even for that matter, Amazon or any other Google searches which you do for learning and things like that. These are all personal. What about, how do companies look at it? Okay, I wanted to focus on the both the sides, that your personal level as well as your professional, because this course is more about tuning you up on the professional side. Okay, so when this question was asked to companies about, especially this is a latest based on the COVID situation, how concerned the companies are because of COVID. What happened in COVID was a kind of a shock to many companies. If you see, more than half of the companies, they are looking at having a very potential and significant impact on their businesses because of COVID. And when you said what happened in COVID, basically, okay, most of us got locked down in our house, we could not go out. So that means the physical interaction, physical transactions which we used to have, the businesses, we used to go to shops and actually physically buy something, everything stopped. Hence, but however, so far the business model was such that it heavily relied on having the physical interaction, physical connect. Okay, but this clearly shows that that's the reason why more than half the companies actually had this very significant to high impact on their businesses. I have got one video which I would like to share with you. Okay, let's have it's a just a small 3-minute video of the CEO of Cisco. Okay, Cisco is a company which works heavily on the networking. They build networking devices, they help connecting or establishing.
They have a competitor to Zoom called the Cisco Webex, right?
Yes, that's correct. Yes. So that company has got some aggressive plans. Just to have a listen to this video.
Now, there's been a huge increase in working from home, prompted, of course, by the pandemic and the technology to support it. Chances are the California giant Cisco is involved at some point in that technology. The company was founded back in 1984 by two Stanford computer scientists, and it has been instrumental in developing the internet. Well, I can speak now to Cisco's chief executive for UK and Ireland, David Meads, who actually thinks that tech skills are more important than ever for young people leaving the current chaotic education system. David, welcome to the program. Thank you for joining us. So why do you think the tech sector could be the answer for school leavers, particularly this year's school leavers who are currently in the exam result chaos?
Well, you know, there's been a tech, a digital skills gap for years, even pre-COVID. The UK Parliament estimated that the skills gap had a potential impact of £60 billion on the GDP for the UK alone. So with COVID, of course, that's just accelerated it because everybody's using technology to a greater extent than they were pre-COVID.
University is becoming increasingly irrelevant then, do you think, to a successful career in tech?
I don't know that they're becoming increasingly irrelevant, but they're no longer the way in which you can get into the tech industry. You know, we have our own graduate program, which we'll continue to invest in, but we're now heavily investing alongside that in the apprenticeship program. And in fact, this year we'll be taking probably 5 times the number of apprentices into our UK businesses as the number of graduates. So it's not an either or. I think it's just another way to access other skill sets that we wouldn't, and a different demographic that we wouldn't necessarily be able to access through the graduate program.
David, let's talk about Cisco then. Of course, there's been a tech revival, to say the least. The stock market's gone crazy for tech stocks of late. Yet Cisco, your company, reporting a first fall in revenue for some 3 years. What's gone wrong?
Well, I don't think anything's gone wrong. What we're seeing is because of the crisis, we're seeing a number of companies who are pausing and reevaluating how they invest in technology. You know, a lot of our technology has historically been providing and equipping head office environments and campus environments. The truth is that many organizations won't see the number of people coming into the office that they did pre-COVID, but that actually pivots to different types of technology, which are more around collaboration tools and security tools. So I think we're seeing a pause in spending, but we expect to see that spending accelerate as people really understand what the new working practice will look like.
Yeah, your CEO Chuck Robbins said that small businesses, your customers, are not having the budget to spend on IT infrastructure. Is that the same in the UK?
I think it's the same the world over, but what we are seeing is that they small businesses in particular, understand now that technology can be the differentiator for them, but how they consume it, it's less about capital outlay now, more about being able to consume technology on demand. So it's different ways to package the technology and make it easier for businesses to then use it as a differentiator.
He flagged $1 billion cost cutting right across the company. Could there be UK job losses on the cards?
Well, we're evaluating that. We're looking as a company wide at how we invest in new areas to accelerate some of our portfolio solutions into the cloud. We'll obviously have to evaluate that over the next few weeks, what the potential impact will be in the UK. But we'll be investing and doubling down in areas where we see huge potential as COVID loosens and we get back to the new normal.
We'll leave it there. Thank you so much for joining us, David Mead, the Chief Executive for UK and Ireland for Cisco.
Okay, so this is what this is just a representative thoughts of most of the business leaders across the globe now. Okay, I just happened to see this and I thought it is so relevant. I hear it all the time from everyone I speak. Okay, and there are a lot of that just 3 minutes video, but it has got punches. Okay, it has got so many points which I actually wanted to discuss with you. Okay, first and foremost, okay, it talks about the tech skill gaps. Okay, that's the reason, you know, yesterday Michelle said that, you know, degrees are irrelevant anymore. It's all about skills. Okay, and it's so true, you know, so I recollect her statement and it is so true. And that is the skill gap which we want to build in a bridge in such a certain way. Okay, that is the reason why we need to own skills and building your own digital skills, so to speak. And if you look at the numbers, you know, what number he mentioned is £60 billion of GDP. So that is the huge impact on overall country's economy. Okay, don't forget the numbers. Okay, it's not matter. What we need to understand is the scale of it. Okay, it is going to impact economy in such a way that it is, and ultimately what is economy, you know, it ultimately comes down to our life. Don't look at it that, oh, it's a problem of big companies or those companies which are not relevant to me. I'm sitting here, I'm a small village, it's not relevant to me. No, it's not. It is going to ultimately impact each one of us some way or the other. Okay, hence it is a prerogative for each one of us to help bridging those skill gaps. Okay, he also mentioned that there will be a lot of ways in which the degrees or the typical education will become irrelevant. Okay, he also spoke about that they are talking about they are thinking of making more apprenticeship programs. So in that program, what it means is that probably they would get coolies or the students much early in the game, and then they will train them on the job. That on the job training, which I spoke yesterday also, is going to be the key thing across many companies are thinking about going into that apprenticeship mode, so that they get or they impart skills which are relevant to their businesses. Okay, then he also spoke about tech investment. So why we need to understand those investment, where companies are investing, because that's where more jobs are going to be. He spoke about collaboration, he spoke about those kind of skills which will be required for us to work in future, though collaboration has always been required. As I said, none of the human endeavors is ever passed out teamwork. So collaboration was always there, but it has become now even more important. And how do we collaborate remotely? That has become one of the big challenge. He also spoke about, if you remember, he was asked, are there going to be job cuts? He did not answer that question. He said that we are looking at the new areas where they can expand. Okay, so this is again restating the same fact which we discussed yesterday. There will be job areas within the companies also. There are going to be new areas where people will be trained, and this has become a norm now. Okay, I started my career in programming or doing some application development in a language called Visual Basic, but now that language is also not very relevant, and I have moved on to learn different skills, different technologies. So continuously learning these new skills is very essential. This course to help you understand that you have to continuously learn. Okay, I'm not teaching you anything, but just letting you know that continuous learn is very important for all of us. Okay, Moving on. Okay, so before we talk about essential digital skills, what I wanted to speak on, I would take a pause. Do you have any thoughts or anything you would like to share? I think we spoke for half an hour. I want to be, you know, just the only person talking. Do you want to speak out or do you have any thoughts? I have not seen any public chat, unmuted. But let me see.
I just want to add, okay, somebody else spoke. Yeah, sorry, Neha, go ahead.
No, I just wanted to say, is there a possibility when a college is preparing a curriculum, say a degree curriculum, can't they include the skills there itself? For example, when I did corporate communications, a one-year degree course, then we had skills, for example, interpersonal skills or Photoshop skills, which they knew are industry relevant. Taught in our degree or whatever course we had. So, I mean, if whenever the course is at the degree or any other course, when skills are taken into consideration, when you talk to the industry leaders and make course according to
That's true. I think that is where world is heading, isn't it? Yesterday I also mentioned that Google themselves, they have come up with just six months certification program, which they have officially they are going to consider that as equivalent to a 4-year degree. So that means the crux of it, what the industry wants, giant company like Google, they are coming up with those certifications. So basically they are thinking of those things. But you're right, you know, why can't even then the normal education system can adopt those things and build or bake it into their curriculum? Yeah, that's a good point, Neha. I think that's where we should head. So Michelle, you wanted to add on to something?
The problem there is that educational institutions are too lost in their own bureaucracy and their own traditional values and conservatism, and industry has moved ahead. So young children here need to understand that, you know, from going to schools and colleges, we are getting one thing and then the market is another. This was the reality 20 years ago when we graduated, as well as, 2020 when some of the young boys are going to pass class 10. I just wanted to say that even though a lot of terminology that Sanjog may have used in the last 15 minutes is very new to you, many of these children may know one-on-one, and you're feeling overwhelmed that, you know, what can I do in tech, and I'm just somebody here and I'm struggling for internet, I know I can barely afford a computer, and, you know, my parents don't understand this. But the truth of the matter is that it's your challenge now to figure out how to get better internet access, to figure out how to earn some money, and to figure out how you can learn something on your own and sit in these remote areas that we are sitting, and no one knows where we are sitting right now. No one knows that, you know, there's a chicken in my backyard right now, or I'm sitting in a chiku farm, I'm providing, you know, you can be providing services to somebody anywhere in the world with your own talent and skill. So not to get overwhelmed that there is this world is something I don't understand, and, you know, things like that. The challenge for these children here, many of them, is to feel that they can contribute in whatever manner it is, and they are already empowered. Just because of lack of opportunity or education or degree or economic resources or cultural realities, which we have told them many times, we must not feel ki hum log kya kar sakte hai dunya mein, we are too small. All the lot of the technology ideas have come from small one individual somewhere. If you look at Hotmail, you look at Facebook, you look at a Raspberry Pi, as Agamyan said, people have got good ideas and they have worked. Okay, so keep that in mind. Don't get confused or lost. And of course, keep updating your knowledge and learning new things. Yeah, we can continue.
Yep. Yeah, that's important, Michelle. That's a good point.
You are now muted.
Yeah, and, I very strongly feel that you don't have to, feel that you will be out of... I don't think system will let you be out of place. You know, you will anyway get to know and give it a time, soak in as much as I can, and spend time. Now enough you has access to some form of internet, some form of information access. Try and read, understand, or if you have questions, reach out to people who you think can answer your questions. So keep learning, you know. This is the age where you need to focus more on learning than anything else. You know, don't worry about the world out there. It will keep doing its own thing. You do what you need to do. Okay. So some essential digital skills, which I actually, all these have been picked up from in UK, in the schools, they talk about those digital skills. Okay. So actually, this is not something which I invented. They speak or they inculcate those skills in the student from very early age, or maybe from sixth standard onwards. They talk about all those things. Let's look at one by one, and I will just elaborate a little bit, though most of it is up there, but I will speak to add some more context to it. So use of devices and handling information. Now, most of you are very familiar with it. Most of you are able to connect to this particular session, how to use your mobile phone, what kind of things you can do on the, you know all those things. But it is still, you know, suppose if you are given a completely brand new device or application, how do you use that? How do you handle that information? How do you learn how to use? And most important, you know, what I always insist even to my team is this point, you know, solving technical problems, solving problem. This is one of the important skill, guys, you have to learn. And it doesn't have to be fancy, you know. Pick up a problem which you are facing in your life today, or what you see around you, and see if can any of your devices, can any of your any of the technologies which you are aware of, can it be used to all those? Okay. And this one actually talks about the technical problem, but it is more of, I would look at it as, in general, any problem which you have in life, or any business problem, or social problem, whatever. Creating and editing the documents, or in the digital media. No longer people are doing, you know, I don't know if this is a good thing or bad. I personally feel it's bad. People have lost weight on the paper, right? Mostly people like, especially people like me who are in IT or have been working in IT for over a period of time. We don't write anything, you know, unfortunately, but I make it a point whenever I'm writing a blog or I'm doing anything, I make a point that I write physically, you know, that sense of writing gives me some confidence, but that's okay. Here it is about making sure that you know how to use tools, you know how to you know, create presentations or spreadsheets. That's why one specific session on this course, the next Saturday course, we are talking about how to create spreadsheets. Okay, how to use different features of spreadsheets. So it's a very, very simple thing. I can tell you, at my level, even my boss's level, the spreadsheets are not going anywhere. Okay, it's simplest tool to organize data and things like that. You must learn how to create and edit and work with those digital medium or digital ways in which we store and retrieve information today. Third thing, communicating. So communication, and again, here more important thing is flexible online activity. Okay, this one, what it means is, I spoke about this multiple times earlier in today's session as well as yesterday. The more you interact, you are leaving behind your digital footprint. Okay, that means yesterday I said that when you watch a video on YouTube knows that, okay, perhaps you like this kind of video, and then it gives you more and more kind of suggestions. Okay, so how does it know that? Because you are yourself leaving behind your activities, the trace of your activities you are leaving behind. How do you manage that? Okay, in Europe, there is this concept of, you know, GDPR, which is nothing but personal data. How people are very particular about personal data. Even if you are an employee, your data cannot be maintained or retained by the organization after you quit. After a certain time, you have to delete that data if I give you a request. Okay, so managing that your online activities and managing the trace which you leave behind is one of the key thing which they have bumped into communication. But yeah, it is one of the part which you have to take care. Then transacting day by day. Yesterday I spoke about the buying experience or anything. Today I don't know, I think in India also, when I visited last year, I think in India also now we have this contactless payment, right? You don't have to actually use money or actually, even for that matter, credit card. You don't have to insert machine, you just tap it and you can do transaction. Online services are an online buy. I'm sure some of you would be doing or buying things on Amazon or Flipkart or those websites. So how do you ensure that they are secure? You know, that is why when I spoke about in the earlier slides, I said security is one of the key aspects which each one of us need to understand. This has got direct implication on your finances. People can steal money. There are a lot of scams which are going on. You want even for in or I'm sure in all the organizations, we have to have a certain we have mandatory training to make sure that we understand the security aspect of it. We don't open email. So it is true for all of you also. Now you guys are new to the technology, maybe not that new. You create your Gmail account, okay? You go visit some website or something. There you are asked to give your details. You give your personal email address. Then you might get some emails, okay? Make sure that unless those mails are relevant or have request them, add this to your parents. Even you know that group, that my parents also, they are not very tech savvy or they are not very clear about what could be right or wrong. I make sure that tell them that, okay, don't open any email attachment. So I'm requesting you all that make sure that you don't open any attachment. You don't click the link which you are not intended or you have not asked for. Don't share your personal bank details. I thought you wouldn't have, but even your parents, don't do those things. This is one area which, guys, even I'm extremely about. And, to my kids also, I make sure that they don't leave their personal email address or information on any website. Please don't do that. Make sure whenever you are buying from the safe websites. Use Amazon. You know, these are safe websites. Don't buy from any damn thing, even if you are getting cheap stuff there. Okay, that's one thing which I'm very, very personally concerned about. And then the last and not the least, which is being responsible. You know, what does this mean? Is now, you know, how social media has been impacting our social life in general. You know, anything which you say or tweet or make a comment or Facebook comment post, you comment on a post, you have to be very responsible. You have to be safe. You have to be protecting the privacy of yourself.
There is one thing, can I say?
Yes.
In email attacks, they will send to a suspicious link. Aren't they called phishing? Phishing, yes. Attacks with a PHN.
Yes. Yes. Phishing attack is very normal. So in common language, what it means is, they send you a link and the moment you click on that link, they will probably get the information from your device automatically. Okay, they sometimes even push viruses or worms, or there is something called as ransomware. So ransomware, what they do is they lock your phone, they will lock your laptop, and then they will ask you money for unlocking it. You know, so these are real threats. Okay, these are really very nasty things which are happening online. So though digital is good, be very, very responsible, be very safe. Okay, I can't stress the importance of it more, but you know, you can read more about it and be responsible about it. Okay, then it is about the privacy. I mentioned about that privacy thing. So make sure that you are responsible for your own privacy, and as well as you are also, sorry, I'm getting distracted. One second. Responsible about protecting your own data as well as protecting someone else's data. Don't make any comments or anything about others also. That is very important. Okay, and the last thing is being digital well-being. What it means is, yesterday Michelle mentioned that, you know, you guys are, most of us are now so much into digital, or all the conferences, all these programs, all these online classes, everything, it's all digital. You know, almost entire our waking life we are in front of screen. So digital well-being, and especially it is taught in the schools here, okay, that make sure that you have offline activities as well. Though it is offline, actually it is like your digital well-being. You actually get yourself off the digital media and go and do something physical. Go outside, play real physical games and things like that. Don't spend time playing games on your mobile phones. Okay, just have digital detox. Okay, why this is important, I think we already spoke about it multiple times, that the future is going to be increasingly digital and interwoven, you know, interwoven with our daily life. Whether you like it or not, most of the things we are going to have some aspect of it going to be digital. Okay, it all the transaction, maybe it will be some part of it will be digital, some will be offline or things like that. So it is getting intertwined with your daily life. And this one also we spoke multiple times, skills are going to be will determine your survival, you know. And you saw in that video where Cisco CEO also said, you know, unless you have skills, they are looking at alternatives of surviving or making sure that the employees are having enough skills so that they can work well, you know. So these skills are going to determine your survival, your well-being, how you get to work, you know, that. So we wanted to talk to you about, if you start doing it right now, see, ultimately everyone needs to build those skills. If you start early adoption advantage, what it means is you will be ahead of your peer group, your friends who have not got those skills, or they are not working on building skills, will have advantage over that. It's as simple as that. It's true in every other thing. All right, so this is about digital, but is digital is all we want? I would say no. You know, that's why I wanted to talk about all these other skills also. You know, these are life skills, I call them. And not just the digital skills, we need to have all those other skills also, especially, and I will give the context or speak about these are actually, it's not new, okay, these were always there, but they are even more relevant now. creativity. You know, do you know the difference between innovation and invention, by the way? So that you understand what innovation and what is invention. And
no, he's asking question, nobody's answering.
Okay, the innovation or invention is a breakthrough of thing and name. Okay, something you start from a scratch and you do something. So that is invention. Okay, and innovation, when we say innovation, it is that incremental change. Doing something in a specific way, you make a small change in that and you get some benefit. Is a very common word used across industries now. You can search for it. Innovation is the buzzword. Every industry, everywhere, you will see innovation. What is it? It is nothing but the creativity which you have. How they say, make a small adjustment to your way of working, and then it gives you some additional advantages, it gives you some benefits. That is the creativity. So every one of us has that creativity. Okay,
well, I can't do it because
we are out of it. You have to only creativity, even innovation, the small incremental change. People feel that, oh, I'm not at all creative. They feel it because they associate creativity with invention or something brand new or something you have to do from scratch. No, it's not that. It's creative. Introduce each one of us is actually capable. Even small kids, they are even more creative than all of us actually. Okay, so look for those small opportunities and that will give you an edge over others. This is what differentiates you from rest of the world. Emotional interview. You know, there have been a lot of. There was an era where we speak about IQ. You know, now IQ is intelligence.
Hello.
Do a Google search, you will see the top 10 critical skills. Okay, you will always see analytical thinking is always on the top or at least in top 5, irrespective of what kind of economy or what kind of trend, as we can say, the whether it is digital or not, you will always need analytical thinking abilities. Okay, many of you would probably associate it with maths or something like that, but it's not just that, okay? It is also about how you convince others, how you talk, how you construct your sentence and things like that. So practice it and all those skills, okay? All these 5 skills, actually it will come with this. And each one of you can have it, okay? Interpersonal communication, how do we exchange information with each other? And in fact, I would also like, it is not just interpersonal, but probably inter-entity, I would say. You know, you also need to probably, yesterday we spoke about it, right? Would you like to work with robots? And most of you said yes. So if you start working with robots, you would probably also need to have some skills to extract information from them. How do we exchange information with them? It is, as you can see here, it is one of the vital skills for this 4th industrial revolution which we are witnessing right now. Okay, yesterday I think Sam, you sent some link where that article was written by a robot or a bot, isn't it? So I read that after the course, and that what it says, you know, I'm not against it, but I'm not against humanity, or I'm not doing something like, I'm here to collaborate with you. I'm here to do what you ask me to do. So what we need to do is we need to understand how to get the machines work for us. Okay. And it is true for even how to get other person work for you. And it is true, even within your household, how do you get your mom and dad to do what you want them to do, right? How to get you something. Those are interpersonal skills. Okay, so look at it very simplistically. I don't want you to think of these skills as something which you will have to learn, or it is only applicable for the working population. No, it is true for each one of us. Okay, and last but not the least is the embracing change. Yesterday also I said the change is happening rapidly. Okay, and embracing change is one of the key thing which every one of us, even for corporations, you know, even for companies who are not embracing change, they are going, you know, Kodak, right? Kodak had been one of the very successful brand for photography, but they ignored the change which was happening because of digital photography or digital technology. They kept themselves to that traditional photography business, and they collapsed, almost collapsed, isn't it? So that embracing change, though, like it is true for human or person, it is also true for the companies also. Okay, so if you have the skill, you will always reskill yourself. Yesterday, I think somebody mentioned, I think Chirag or somebody you mentioned, right? You keep learning new skills, right? So how do you do that? If you have this ability to embrace the change, then only you will be able to learn. So as Michelle also said just some time back, that you will get opportunities to learn. Just be open-minded, and it will come, okay? Be open for change, and things will come to you. All right, this is all I wanted to say. I think we are right on time. Any thoughts, anyone would like to share something? Any observations, comments?
No, nothing actually. I'm just in a thought. I'm trying to say something. You know, automation is a buzzword, right, in our industry. Maybe in the end, you know, in the system side, is a word. So, in the 8 hours is our time, you know, office time is 8 hours or might be 10 hours being in office. So, you know, and it should have to be you know, a minimum 5 hour work, you know. Saying that it's a good thing in ITC, you know, ICT, in information communication technology.
Yeah,
it's going to come.
Okay,
just to enjoy, just in a thought, that nothing else.
Yeah, yeah, that's a good point.
Learning new things.
Yep. You are now unmuted. I have a question. What do you think? most interesting technologies.
What do you think? It depends on how we are going to use it, right? So there are all these things are very interesting, but I always look at technologies in terms of how you use it to solve real problems. You can solve problems with simple technology also. For me, that is more important than the advanced technologies. So I don't focus on the technologies, and I don't think I focus too much on these are the new buzzword things, but I think it is more important how you use technologies. Okay, to my mind, that is more important, Agam man.
Okay.
You might have, I have understanding of various technologies now. So start thinking of use this. Okay, and do you see any real and build on that? We then depending. See, there are new technologies coming every now and then. Okay, it is not impossible for us to understand and learn each and every technology. What's more important is to learn a few and try and implement those things and see how what results you get. Okay, that's more important. Okay, I see Agaman, you also mentioned you are learning JavaScript, so which is good. See, one programming language is enough actually. You can do wonders with just one programming language.
Yeah, but I think it's good. But the thing is, many are like specializing. It's hard to find like a one language does it all. Although you can do it, it's like you can do anything with the language. It's the thing is, if your language specializes in it, it usually does it better.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. That's why I said, what you want to focus on and see if you can solve something with whatever you know, right? That's more important than anything else.
I'm actually run a Linux on my machine. I don't have Windows.
Okay, that's good. Okay, anyone else? Yeah. I think Michelle, you made the logic you need. It's not like
programming.
Yes. Okay. Anything else? Anyone has anything to chime?
You are now muted.
Okay, if there are no more questions, then shall we wrap up for today, and then we will meet on Tuesday as we speak.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Next Saturday,
5:00. Yeah. Next Saturday. Okay. All right. Thank you, everyone. Have a good rest of the evening.
Lot, yeah.
We'll speak next week.
Thank you.
All right. Cheers. Bye.
See you next.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Bye. Bye.